What's up, ladies? Filming.
Dan, where'd they go?
Get off my porch!
Give me a rundown. This guy's gonna be in an interview in the end. Jeremy's gonna be in it as well. What's going on? It's Monday. It's New Monday. Start.
New start.
We're get away from me because you're not. I can't get that much of you. Oh yeah.
We're gonna be doing squats up to a heavy single at 90% every day except for Sunday.
Yep.
And then today we're gonna be working on Tabata for our conditioning, and in between that we're gonna do a 20-minute EMOM at 80% snatch, which for us will be about 100 kilos.
Yeah, we've done this before. I'll try and just make it super short and sweet, and it'll look cool. Hey, Brandy. Class is pretty busy tonight. Yeah, that's about it. Hey, Jeremy. Cool, man. Cool.
Okay. So, Zach mentioned that we are doing, we work up to 90% for a single back squat. 6 days a week. It's basically called the path to 90%. So, in about 10 minutes, you'll do 5 or 6 sets. So, like, right now, I'm starting kind of low, so I'm working up to 315. So, I'll go 135 for 5. 185 for 4, 225 for 3, 275 for 2, I'll go 300 for a single and 315 for a single, and then you're done. But every day, getting under a bar, you're going to build that muscular endurance. It's kind of good just to keep squatting every day, or at least as much as you can, without pain. So that's what he meant by squatting up to 90% every day. What's up, guys? So we just finished that 20 minute, every minute on the minute.
Didn't go well.
I made probably 17 of 20. I think I only missed 3 times, so it didn't go that bad for me. I mean, not that it went bad for either of us. Zach just had more misses, but it's not like a miss is a bad thing technically. He still got the pull. He was under the bar every time. So we worked up to, we started at 225. We ended at 235. So I think I hit 5 reps at the end at 235. Zach had a lot of good pulls at 235. So we're gonna do some snatch deadlifts now.
5 sets of 3 with a
3 second descent. Yeah. We're going at 275, straps included. Then we're gonna do a wad, which is all Tabata, and then we're gonna interview Tweedle Dee and Tweedle Dum, aka Marc and Jeremy. Bye. See ya. Who's getting
naked? We got some nice lips, boy.
One of them feet.
We got a pretty mouth, boy.
Got a posy shower.
Okay, let's try this again. So, we're going to do the same thing that we basically did when we interviewed Ely, except they're going to get a question where they get to introduce themselves, and then Zach's going to put them kind of on the spot. They'll have to answer from there. So, this is Jeremy, this is Marc. Basically, let's just go Jeremy first.
All right.
How long have you been CrossFitting or weightlifting? And what got you involved in it?
Basically, I started about 2.5 years ago, and what got me involved, first off, was that people I camp with already did CrossFit, and they talked me into trying it. But the main reason was I was scheduled to go in for a knee surgery, almost a knee replacement, and I decided to try to strengthen my leg before I went to destroy it by doing a knee surgery.
So basically like a natural
PT. Natural PT, build my leg up, the strength around it without using the ligaments, try to compensate for it, basically.
So saying that, did you have to get surgery?
I did not have to get surgery when I started CrossFit, but I have had a knee surgery since I've been in CrossFit.
I was going to say, it would have been such a good story if you were like, no, it saved everything.
No, I actually hurt CrossFit. Yeah, I didn't hurt because of CrossFit. I actually started coaching a basketball team, and I hurt it training basketball.
Coach Jeremy.
So. All
right, Mark, what about you?
So I started in 2010.
5 years.
Yeah.
Why aren't you better?
Yeah, I know. Five. I should be a lot bigger and stronger.
Weird.
I know. So weird. Still working on those pull-ups now. But my girlfriend at the time, now wife, so we always work out.
So CrossFit gets you married, huh?
Yeah.
So when we first started dating, we always used to work out together and go to the gym together and go to snap and spinning or whatever the heck she wanted to do at the time. And, you know, that stuff gets boring. And
get out of here.
Hey.
Leave.
We got business to do.
In the middle of something. Keep
yeah,
going, Mark.
Real so, important.
So that's like, you know, in college and high school, you always do the weight training and stuff, and the stuff gets boring over time. So the wife was like, hey, there's a Groupon with this trainer that I know, which is the guy that just walked out of here.
Sam.
His name's Sam.
You kind of know him, but he's an asshole.
And she's like, he's doing this CrossFit thing where you go and it's like group training. And I'm like, I don't need group training. It's like, I know what to do. Like, I know how to work out. And anyways, there's a Groupon. And I remember we were skiing actually out west visiting her, now my sister-in-law. And she's like, hey, there's a Groupon. Let's get it because it's not that expensive if we do it. It's like $50 a person for 3 months, blah, blah, blah. So we got that. And then I was introduced to Sam and kind of fell in love with it.
I started on a Groupon too, so it's kind of fun. Yeah. It is kind of weird.
I started on a Groupon also.
Yeah.
Did we all start on a Groupon?
I started because my girlfriend worked with the owner of the gym at another place and was like, hey, let's try this CrossFit thing. What the hell is CrossFit?
It was so foreign at first. All right, next question. Somewhat short.
Do you have another one?
No.
Or me?
No, that's it.
So my question is, these two have just recently switched over to zero CrossFit and have been, 9 week lifting cycle?
We're in our fourth week?
Four week,
5 days a week.
So strictly Oli.
Strictly. Yeah,
this James Tatum.
James Tatum strength program.
Yep.
So my question to you guys is, since you guys have switched, what are you guys doing differently to keep your bodies prepped on a day-to-day basis, doing that kind of volume?
Yeah, especially because that's a good question, because right now they're almost heavy snatching and heavy clean and jerking almost every day.
Every day. Oh, yeah.
Right? Where, like, in a normal CrossFit routine, you're going to snatch maybe once a week and clean and jerk maybe once a week. And if you're just doing it for leisure, you're not going to really go that heavy.
No. Right?
So going from doing CrossFit for, you know, 5 years, 2.5 plus, you know, whatever, what is your recovery like now that you have so much overhead work, so much squatting?
Well, I think what I've done differently mainly is diet. I've had to watch what I do for recovery, you know, supplements, stuff like that. But mainly, I find mobility has been the key for me. I mean, I'm still sore, I'm still tired, but every day I get up and I hit the roll with the crossball. Stretch. I have to keep my body moving because the volume is so much higher. If I was sit still, I notice if I take a day off, we're lifting 5 days a week in the cycle. If I take that one day off and I don't do anything, I come back and it's like starting over again. It's just ridiculously super tight. You gotta, you know, with diet and exercise, just to stay that mobile so you can come in and do that.
I think mobility is overlooked. That's what I'm gonna
think. Yeah.
Especially in the weightlifting community. I know with all the, you know, the online programs and YouTube videos and mobility WOD, ROM WOD, stuff like that, it's kind of increasing. But I think for a long time, mobility was like not even looked at.
Well, the mobility is usually like a 2 to 5, 6 minute deal where I'm spending a half hour to 45 minutes, you know, stretching and.
Like 2 minutes.
Oh.
You know.
Two more minutes.
Flash. guys.
Sam's got to clean up after us. Anyway,
oh, shoot.
Wait, what are you guys going to talk about?
No, we're in the middle of something. They got Mark's got to answer his question now, too.
Are you really videotaping?
Yeah, it's filming right now.
Of course we're
Do you want to say hi? Come on in. Come on, Katie.
Come on, Katie.
Let's go, KP.
Camera shy?
All right, so I'll keep it short. The main thing that I've noticed...
Come on, Catherine! In the middle of filming!
You gonna cut this out?
No.
Mom!
Mom!
Me alone!
Okay. Okay. Keep it short.
The main thing I've noticed is I'm incredibly, sore, but in a completely different way than doing wads. Like, when you do wads, you know, you do 150 wall balls in 30 snatches... Like, your legs the next day, like, in the shower are shaking because you can't even, like, stand. Or you do a ton of shoulder presses and washing your hair at the end of the day. You're seriously shaking. I was just brushing my teeth, shaking. This is just, like, a different, you almost, like, ache. Because
the core.
Because like your joints.
Yeah. It's not a muscle thing. It's more of a joint.
And I feel like it's a mobility thing, too, because we're lifting so heavy, so hard, that... If you don't stay mobile like that, everything just gets real tight, and you just gotta really keep it loose. I mean, I roll out.
See, I never felt this tight doing a wad. Like, doing a wad, I always felt like, because you do the volume, but it's a lot lighter, so you just kept doing more to keep opening yourself up.
Yeah.
When you're doing the strength stuff, and you're snatching, and you're doing 18 to 20 reps at a heavy weight.
Yeah, like 80%
plus. 80%
plus.
I don't get sore, I just ache.
Yeah, I just ache. Just catch your
where nutrition comes in, which is also, you know, fish oils and omegas and stuff like that.
I guess, finally, just to kind of piggyback on that, what would a typical off day look like? Being that you're not really coming in, say you go out 5 days in a row or whatever, what would an off day look like? Do you
eat?
Mobilize?
Yeah.
Do you do active
I'm sure your metabolism is flying.
Dude, I've realized that since I started this, I am so hungry. I actually have to, like, control it.
Yeah, I have to eat more now because of volume of weight rather than...
Right.
It's more a volume meal, a healthier meal, like substance.
Yeah.
And not try to, with WOD where you need the burst of energy, where here it's more of a longevity. You got to have a lot.
You need to be fueled up.
I need to be fueled up for that.
Because we're here for 2 hours.
Yeah, a 2-hour lifting cycle.
You need like a good solid meal beforehand to get through it. Huh?
No, he like grabbed it. I was like, dude, wait till after we're done.
Oh, sorry.
All right, well, we hope that you liked kind of like the interview thing. This is good just because, I mean, we train with these guys every day. You might not see them in every single vlog, but they're grinding in here with us, you know, every single day of the week. So whether they're doing something else outside of what Zach and I are doing or what other members are doing, we're still kind of, you know, pushing each other in and out of the gym, making fun of each other. but yeah, so leave some comments or just tell us at the gym what you guys liked.
Comments. Leave comments so we can make this better.
Yeah.
And just give
some
likes.
Feedback, yeah. Thanks for watching. I'm gonna steal Sam's thing. What does he do? He claps.
Yeah.
Boom.